गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. टूडे आई एम मुस्कान कुमारी फ्रॉम 8B इज गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट फ्यू वर्ड्स ऑन नेशनल कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डे. द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डे वॉज नॉट सेलिब्रेटेड बिफोर द ईयर 2015. इन द ईयर 2015 आर ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी मार्क्ड नवंबर 26 एज द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन इंडिया टू सेलिब्रेट द 125th बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ B.R. अम्बेडकर. As we all know that India got independence on 15th August 1947, on 26 January 1950 the Constitution of India came into the effect. That is the reason why we celebrate Republic Day. But now you might be thinking about the history of how the Constitution of India came into the effect. The Constitution Assembly was formed, which consisted of elected representatives from various fields. The important members were Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Jawaharlal Nehru, B.N. Rao and Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. The Constitutional Assembly met for 166 days before the Constitution was adopted. During the adaptation, two handwritten copies, each in Hindi and English, were signed by the Constitutional Assembly members on January 24, 1950. By January 26, 1950, the Constitution of India came into the effect, and from that day it becomes the law of the land. Basically, Constitution Day aims to celebrate the significance of our Indian Constitution. It is the day to celebrate the life of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. The Constitution declares India a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. It guarantees every Indian citizen justice, equality and liberty and endeavors to promote. The Constitution of India lays down the framework for the political code, structure, procedure, powers and the duties of the government bodies, and provides the fundamental rights, core principles to every citizens of the India. Constitution Day is celebrated in schools and colleges to spread the awareness that how about the importance of Indian Constitution. Thank you.
Good morning everyone. Today I, Zanzafi Chaudhary of Class 8B, is here to speak some of the words on National Constitution Day. The Constitution Day is celebrated every year on 26th November to honor the adaptation of the Constitution of India. The Constitution Day is also called National Law Day or Samvidhan Divas. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is also known as the father of the Constitution. In the year 2015, our Prime Minister Narendra Modi marked November 26 as the Constitution Day of India to celebrate 125th birthday of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Fraternity. The Constitution of India lays down the
आर अम्बेडकर, जवाहरलाल नेहरू, बी एन राव एंड सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल. द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल असेंबली मेट फॉर 166 डेज बिफोर द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन was adopted. During the adoption, two hands written copies, each in Hindi and English, were signed by the Constitutional Assembly members on January 24, 1950. By January 26, 1950, the Constitution of India came into effect, and from that day, it became the law of the land. Constitution Day aims to celebrate the significance of Indian Constitution. It is a day that also celebrates the life of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. The Constitution declares India as a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. It guarantees the Indian citizens justice, equality and liberty, and endeavors to promote fraternity. The Constitution of India lays down the frame.
My name is Daksh Bhardwaj from Class 6th A, and today on this auspicious Constitution Day, I am going to explain one fundamental right, that is right to freedom of religion. In our country, each and every citizen is free to choose their religion and do what his and her religion tells them to do. So, Muslims fast during Ramzan, Christians during Lent, and Hindus during Navratri. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning everyone. My name is Mukul Sharma from Class 6B, and today I am going to give a speech on right to own property. Right to own property or right to own property is often classified as human right for natural persons regarding their positions. A general recognition of a right to private property is found more rarely and typically have one constitutes in so far as property is owned by legal persons and where it is used for productions rather than constitutions. A right to property is recognized in Article 17 but not in recognized in International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, on the International on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights also, the European Covenant on Human Rights in Protocol 1 and Article 1 acknowledges a right for natural and legal person to peaceful enjoyment of his possessions, right to general interest or to secure the payment.
Good morning everyone. Today I, Mohammed Umar of Class 6B, is here to speak one fundamental. So I am going to tell about fundamental rights of freedom. The right to freedom is one of the most fundamental rights assured by the Indian Constitution. It is because of the prevalence of these freedoms that make democracy is purposeful. Right to freedom generates liberty of expression and speech, association or assembly or cooperatives, movements. Right to practice any occupation or profession. Right to liberty and life protection and offenses against detention and arrest in many cases. Right to freedom consists of four main laws. The right to freedom to the citizens of getting assembled anywhere in India without carrying weapons or arms along with them. The freedom to form cooperative societies, association or unions. The freedom to travel to any part of India but in order to control epidemics. Thank you and have a nice day.